welcome back to another episode of Horizon Zero Dawn. Possibly the final episode of the story, who knows? I don't know how many missions there are, but... So we're going to head all the way up there to do the bit of climb, but... First things first, we're going to get a mount to go there, because it's a wee bit of a distance, and look, poking his head over the corner being like, "Did you say mount?" I did say mount now. Come here, you cheeky little devil.
The way to the mountain will be hard. Ferocious machines prowl every step of the climb.
They're corrupted.
Not corrupted, but they will not tolerate humans.
So what else is new?
Yeah, but apparently you'll meet me up here, so why didn't you just do it together? Then we could have took them down together.
Stalkers in the open. Watchers on the other side.
Okay. Oh, this is a big jump. Bruh.
Do they think they're guarding Gaia?
I doubt they think at all. More like an instinct, gathering them to her grave.
Summer's over here, there'd be no... Oh. That wasn't too difficult. No doubt Eclipse are up here waiting though. Somehow they managed to get past all those animals. Machines.
They're scanning for me.
Is that a storm bird?
Guessing that I'm almost there.
Correct.
Oh.
He's got no more actual weak points that I can attack. Like, that's it. Half health, all his weak points are down. Jesus Christ, that's why I hate this fucking fight.
Yeah. On our own.
Don't know what else I can do. There isn't a lot else I can do. Fucking cheese. Surely. That's a hit. I need health. We should have him. Oh, thank God for that. Jeez Louise. Oh, I hate you, Stormbird. I fucking hate you. On the plus side, after we save the world, we can continue the Hunter's quest now.
This snow's got a bite out here. So you've been in here before?
To a point. You'll see.
You made a climbing path for me, but left an army of machines for me to deal with?
Since when were machines any obstacle for you? If you could fly, I wouldn't have bothered with a climbing path either.
It's obviously the way down.
This is exactly the kind of place I expected to find you in, Silence.
Thank you. It's one of many workshops I've constructed over the years. For years, I tried to get through this hatch. I drilled, I burned, I blasted. But we both know that you won't have any trouble getting through.
You make it sound like I should apologize.
Not at all. It never occurred to me that the way through would not be with force, but with a key. A key in human form. The failure of imagination was mine, not yours.
Looks like you've spent a lot of time here.
19 years ago, a great explosion destroyed this mountain. Gaia's death, your birth. The echo could be heard as far as the claim. Ash darkened the skies. How they fretted in Meridian as they tried to read this omen. The crater burned for weeks, but when it cooled, I was the first to behold what lay within. Over time, the machines closed ranks to protect it. Useful. Soon, no one dared to come here. Except me.
In her message, Gaia said we could restore her, but after seeing the damage, how could that be?
She said any effort to repair her must come after Hades is destroyed. I concur. Rebuilding the terraforming system now might allow Hades to use it as a weapon. Because of Gaia's sacrifice, it has been forced to search for means that are less convenient.
But do you think it's even possible to restore Gaia?
You know what the Cauldrons are capable of. How they fabricate any technology necessary to create a machine. By the same principle, it should be possible to replicate every technology necessary to repair Gaia. That would take years. We're counting the time we have left by the hour.
I thought you might actually be here this time. Actually, here.
Why? My presence is unnecessary. You don't need my help to pass through this door. You were the one born to do this, not me.
It's time for me to head in.
Yes. When you find the Master Override, you will gain the power to defeat Hades. Everything depends on you.
All right.
Genetic identity confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. You are cleared to proceed.
Cool. Dr. Sobek coming through. God, there's gonna be even more. Oh, there are. There's so many of these. Oh, I can't listen to them. There's too many. We'll listen to them all later.
Mind your footing.
Oh my God. Could have warned me a bit earlier. So how does one...
Guess that's my way across. It's, held like this for 19 years, right?
Well...
Don't answer. Oh, glad that's over.
Are you in there?
Not this way. Maybe further up the shaft.
I need to climb up.
This must have been where they lived. What's left of it? Once this was all enclosed by rock and metal.
But showers. Thank you.
Elizabeth's room. I know it. She didn't even get a chance to unpack. These are her journals. Elizabeth's journals. And they're all destroyed?
Scan them. The Focus can rebuild them, but the process is slow. To us, it seems a powerful device, but its engine is tiny and limited.
How slow?
Days, weeks, years. Concern yourself with stopping Hades and extending the future, and you might live long enough to hear them.
All right.
Logging this 6 hours after final deployment of Gaia Prime. This morning, an access port seal malfunctioned. Gaia Prime's port seals were designed to close with a seam of less than 2 millimeters. But this one closed with a 10 millimeter gap. Enough for an energy signature to bleed through. Enough for the swarm to detect this facility. Enough for Gaia to be discovered and destroyed. Enough to end the future we worked so hard to make possible. Unless the hatch servos were manually re-engaged from the outside. I'm now switching to a recording of the event.
Well, I'm not going out there. Not what I signed up for. Either we send someone out, or all of this was for nothing.
It should be Liz's decision.
So when is she going to get here?
She said 5 minutes. You don't think...
Oh no. Okay, everyone. I've repaired the seal. Gaia?
Seal closure at 1.4 millimeters. Confirmed.
Elizabeth, no. We'll find a way to bring you back in.
It's not gonna happen, the swarm's too close.
Oh shit.
Really, it's alright. Gaia's complete. She'll take care of things from here on out, that's what she does.
Not like this. There's so much we-
Guys, you know me, I'm no good at endings. At letting things end, so, let's not.
So... Happy trails, Liz. And, see you around.
Yeah. Take care of each other, all right?
Liz.
I'm okay with this. I want to go home. Goodbye.
That was the last transmission of Elizabeth Sobeck. She gave everything for the hope of life on this planet. And we are all in her debt.
Aloy?
She's gone. Really gone.
You knew she couldn't have survived, Aloy. And her achievements were... beyond exceptional.
While her people bickered, she was the one who took responsibility. The only one who could.
She was better than them.
That's not what I said.
She was. You shouldn't be afraid to admit it.
Can't you just for one moment stop calculating and let yourself feel? She sacrificed herself for her friends, for the future, for life on Earth. Doesn't that stir anything in you? The generosity of it.
You're trying to invest her decision with something magical. It was a rational choice, not based on sentimentality.
You're wrong. Remember, she knew it wasn't enough for Gaia to think. She taught Gaia to feel, to care, to sacrifice, to believe in life, enough to fight against hopelessness. If it wasn't for that sentimentality, life would have ended. You and I would never have existed.
Your argument is sound. I'm sorry for your loss.
She said she wanted to go home. Maybe.
What?
Nothing. It's time to go on.
Alright guys, we're going to leave that episode right there. I hope you enjoyed it. We had the Stormbird fight, and then we found out that Elizabeth actually died. So if you enjoyed this episode, make sure you hit that like button, and make sure you come back for the last few episodes of Horizon Zero Dawn. Have a nice day, and ta-ra!